तत्वतः त्यक्त्वा देहं पुनर्जन्म नैति मामेति सोचनं. दैट इज व्हाई वी सेलिब्रेट द अपीयरेंस ऑफ द लॉर्ड, वेयर वी कैन हियर अबाउट हिम. व्हेन वी हियर अबाउट द लॉर्ड, व्हेन वी हियर अबाउट हिज एक्टिविटीज, इट इज प्यूरिफाइंग. एंड व्हेन दैट प्यूरिफिकेशन हैपेंस, वी मेक प्रोग्रेस टुवर्ड्स ओवरकमिंग द साइकिल ऑफ बर्थ एंड डेथ, एज कृष्णा हिमसेल्फ सेड इन भगवद गीता. फर्स्ट थिंग, द डिफरेंस बिटवीन आवर बर्थ एंड कृष्णास बर्थ, दे आर नॉट द सेम, दिस इज दिव्यम. Second thing which I spoke about is when actually Krishna took birth. I did mention that Krishna took birth in a jail. But what happened actually? When Krishna took birth, anything different happened? Like all of us, we took birth at some point in time. Our mothers had to go through a lot of pain. And we just took birth. What was so great about it? And what was great about Krishna's birth? I will not say from my words, this is from the scriptures, Srimad Bhagavatam, very beautiful verse. So this is the narrator of Bhagavatam, Sukadeva Goswami, is telling what happened when Krishna took birth. Shri Suka Uvacha Atha Sarva Gunopetaha Kalaha Paramasovhanaha Yarhi Eva Jana Janmarksham Santarksha Grahatarakam निसःप्रसेदुर्गगनं निर्मूलोदोगनोदयं महीमङ्गलभूयिष्ठा पूरग्रामव्रजाकरा नद्यः प्रसन्नसलिला हृदया जलरूहश्रिया द्विजैकुलसन्नादस्तवका वनराज्यवनःप्रिया वायुवायुसुखस्पर्शः पुण्यगन्धवरशुचिः अग्नयश्च द्विजात्मनं सान्तास्तत्र समैन्धतः मानांसि असां प्रसन्नानि साधूनामसुरद्रुहां जायमाने जने तस्मिन् नेदुर्दुन्दुभ्यासनम् संस्कृत वर्स. जस्ट हियर द मीनिंग ऑफ दिस वर्स. एंड कृष्णा टुक बर्थ. Thereafter, at the auspicious time for the appearance of the Lord, the entire universe was surcharged with all the qualities of goodness, beauty, and peace. The constellation Rohini appeared, as did stars like Ashwini, the sun, the moon, and the other stars and planets were very peaceful. All directions appeared extremely pleasing. And the beautiful stars twinkled in the cloudless sky, decorated with towns, villages, mines, and pasturing grounds. The earth seemed all auspicious. The rivers flowed with clear water, and the lakes and vast reservoirs full of lilies and lotuses were extraordinarily beautiful. And the trees and green plants full of flowers and leaves, pleasing to the eyes. Birds like cuckoos and swarms of bees began chanting with sweet voices for the sake of the demigods. A pure breeze began to blow, easing the sense of touch and bearing the aroma of flowers. And when the Brahmanas, engaging in ritualistic ceremonies, ignited their fires according to Vedic principles, the fires burned steadily, undisturbed by the breeze. Thus, when the birthless Lord Krishna, the Supreme Personality of Godhead, was about to appear, the saints and Brahmanas, who had always been disturbed by demons like Kamsa and his men, felt peace within the core of their hearts, and kettle drums simultaneously vibrated from the upper planetary system. It's a long description, but if you see one word, if you see in this verse, it's called Kala Sobhanam. The time which was inauspicious became auspicious when the Lord appeared. Not just the time which became auspicious, it also brought beauty, goodness, and peace and tranquility. We all in this material world, irrespective of who I am, where I am coming from, what I am doing, all are looking for peace. And that peace, when we are looking for, we don't know really how we can achieve peace. But here it is mentioned, when the Lord appeared, it was a cloudy sky, it was dark, it was Ashtami. He appeared in the jail, but just because he appeared, everything around became auspicious. The ocean became calm. The river started flowing steadily. Everything was auspicious. So our acharyas say that this word kalaha paramasovanaha, favorable and auspicious time for all points of view, is a very significant thing and it is worth meditating upon. So like this verse is telling, the brahmanas whose minds were very much disturbed by Kamsa were able to peacefully continue with ritualistic ceremonies at the time of Lord's appearance without any disturbance. We can also lead a peaceful and a blissful life if we welcome the Lord in our hearts every day. Mind you, Janmashtami is not just one day which happens once a year, which we remember the Lord and we forget. We can invoke the presence of the Lord in our heart every day. And if we do that, like it is mentioned, the brahmanas were able to overcome the disturbances of the demoniac person Kamsa by the advent of the Lord and became peaceful. Similarly, all of us also can invoke the presence of the Lord in our heart and can become peaceful and blissful. So, this is the second point which I was telling. When the Lord appeared, what happened? First was, the Lord's birth was different from any one of us. Divyam, that is transcendental. Second thing, how when the Lord appears in any place, how the whole thing changes. How just by the presence of the Lord, all inauspicious thing vanishes and it becomes auspicious. In Bhagavad Gita also it is mentioned. Actually, imagine, you know, all of us, we have our well-wishers who think well about us, who wish us luck. Our parents, our relatives, our near and dear ones who want us to succeed, who want us to become famous, whatever it is. Now, if those well-wishers are not present in our life, if there is no one who is there to wish us luck, no one who is there to take care of us, how life will be so uncertain and precarious and not cared for, how bad it will be. But the people that we think who are our real well-wishers, they do not last for long. The verse in Bhagavatam, it says, Deha Patya Kalatradishu Atma Sanyeshu Asat Sopi. These are asat. Even if they want to wish us well, they are our well-wishers, they want us to succeed in life, they cannot be always there with us. But the scriptures is telling, there is one well-wisher who is always present, who is always there in each one of our hearts. There is no discrimination. Oh, you are from Japan, then I will not be there in your heart. I am from South India, so I will be there in your heart, but not in North India's heart. No. In every single person's heart, the Lord is present. And the verse in Bhagavad Gita, it says, Bhuktaram yajna tapasam sarva loka maheshwaram suhrudam sarva bhutanam jnantvam aham santi marchati. There is a word which is used there, suhrudam. Actually, the biggest, the most powerful, the most intimate, the biggest well-wisher of each one of us is the Supreme Lord Himself. That's why He is called Suhrut, Suhrudana. Bhoktaram Yogya Tapasam, Bhoktaram Yogya Tapasam, Sarva Loka Maheshwaram, Suhrudam Sarva Bhutana. He is the biggest well-wisher of each one of us, and He is present in our hearts. Now, the important question which comes is, how do we invoke His presence? You can say that the Lord was there and 5,000 years ago He appeared and the whole atmosphere became auspicious. Now I am here in this age. I am not even in India. I am not even in Vrindavan. I am in Boston. How can I invoke the presence of the Lord in my heart? What should I do so that the Lord appears in my heart and all the darkness of the doubts and the miseries disappear from our heart? What is the thing that we can do? Here is the clue. If you do this, it is guaranteed kala sovana. The kala, the time, will become auspicious. What is it that you have to do? To invoke the presence of the Lord, you don't need any external means. The only thing that you have to do is chant the names of the Lord. And it is very simple. You don't have to, you know, spend any money, you have to go anywhere, nothing. The Lord and the scriptures say that the Lord is non-different from His name, because He is the Supreme Absolute Truth. So when we chant the names of the Lord, let's say we chanted the names of the Lord at the beginning, I'm repeating a mantra, you can repeat after me, Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna.
I thought I asked you to repeat, you can repeat loudly.
Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. So this mantra, the mantra that we just chanted, is it helps us to come in touch with the internal energy of the Lord. It helps us to associate with the Lord. The moment we do that, all inauspicious thing in our life vanishes. All inauspicious thing. Everything vanishes. And this mantra is the way we just chanted, it is called japa. Or you know, you are chanting alone. There is another form where you know the chanting happens, where together we can all chant. And the process is so simple, joyful and blissful that you don't have to sit in one place and close your eyes and meditate on something which is impersonal or void, nothing. Just participate in kirtan, in chanting, singing and dancing and experience the bliss. Very beautifully Bhagavatam says, there is a verse which says, Sabedadhatu kadavim parasya duranta virya syuratanga pane yomayaya santatayanu bhritya bhaje tatatpada saroj gandham. The beginning I told about how the Lord's appearance and birth is divyam, and we have to know it in tattvataha, in totality, in completeness. The process of knowing the Lord in completeness and totality is to engage in devotional service. All of you got a chance to offer flowers to the Lord. It's a small service. It is the beginning of your spiritual life of knowing the Lord, if some of you have not done and you are doing it for the first time. Very, very auspicious. And as I said, like the Lord appeared and everything, the whole environment became auspicious. Similarly, when we are chanting the names of the Lord, everything becomes auspicious. What we will do now, this is something very interesting, and you will be amazed by this. We are going to chant the names of the Lord, and we will not sit the way we are sitting in a quiet, serious, in a somber mood. We will do it in a very, very different way. So to explain and to illustrate that, I would request each one of you to kindly stand up. Now, what I will do, you have to follow after me. Okay? And mind, it's as I said, you know, we can actually invoke auspiciousness right now. Not just right now, at any point in time, anywhere. If you are able to remember the names of the Lord, that brings the auspiciousness. So what we are going to do is, we chanted the mantra, which is also displayed. We will chant this mantra one more time, and then I will tell you what needs to be done. You can repeat after me. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna.
I couldn't hear fully.
Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna.
Krishna, Krishna, Hare Hare.
Krishna, Krishna, Hare Hare.
Hare Rama, Hare Rama. Rama Rama Hare Hare.
So now I'm going to demonstrate something which we will do here. Then we have some more performances, and then we will break for dinner prasadam. So what you have to do is, you have to raise your hands. Yeah, I'll show you. Just raise your hands like this. It's not yoga. It's actually it's the topmost yoga, it's bhakti yoga. So now after that, you can see what I'm doing and you can repeat after me. So you have to dance, you have to just take your step on the right like this. Yeah, the right foot goes the other way. Yeah, right, yeah. Okay, yeah, perfect. And then the left foot goes like this. So it's like this. Okay. Yeah. It's like some yogic exercise, whatever you have learned. but it is, the benefits are far higher. Okay, so what I'll do is, we will sing and we will chant and you can repeat. So mind you, the auspiciousness comes by chanting those mantra. So you repeat that sound when I chant and then we will start doing this. Okay, let's do this. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna. Krishna Krishna Hare Hare,
Krishna Krishna Hare Hare,
Hare Rama Hare Rama,
Hare Rama Hare Rama,
Rama Rama Hare Hare,
Rama Rama Hare Hare.
One more time, you have to chant. So I know it is a little difficult now, but it will become very easy when we have the musical instruments. But before it happens, you have to show me that you can do it. Chant. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, I'll repeat after you.
Krishna, Krishna, Hare Hare.
Krishna, Krishna, Hare Hare. I was supposed to repeat after you. The next line.
Hare Rama, Hare Rama.
Hare Rama, Hare Rama.
Rama, Rama, Hare Hare.
Rama, Rama, Hare Hare. Rama, Rama, Hare Hare. One more time, loudly. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna,
Krishna Krishna,
Hare Hare,
Krishna Krishna,
Hare Rama, Hare Rama,
Hare Rama,
Hare Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna,
Krishna
Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama,
Hare Rama, Hare Rama,
Rama Rama, Hare Hare,
Rama Rama, Hare Hare,
Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna,
Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna,
Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare,
Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare,
Hare Rama, Hare Rama,
Hare Rama, Hare Rama,
Rama Rama, Hare Hare.
Feeling
Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna,
Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna,
Krishna Krishna, Hare
Hare,
Hare Rama, Hare Rama,
Rama
Rama, Hare
Hare.
Now participate in this wonderful kirtan which will start. We will all sit, we will stand only and we will just participate in this dance. I just showed you. You all also learned, you have become experts now. So you have to chant, you have to produce this song as well as dance.
Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Hare,